2022, ordinance number 2012-64, to amend the city code for the purpose of requiring council approval by resolution for construction and professional service contract with a value greater than $100,000, and for all contract modifications that increase the contract by 18% or $25,000, whichever is greater.
And that paper is being stricken?
And that paper is going to be stricken. Item number 3, ordinance number 2012-141, to amend the city code by adding new sections, number 14 through 16 and through 14 through 22, for the purpose of establishing a derelict building abatement program. And that paper is going to be continued until January 28th.
Okay, any questions?
Item number 4, ordinance number 2012-192, to amend the city code for the purpose of exempting new businesses that locate within the city and business, professional, and occupational taxes for a period not to exceed 2 years. That paper is going to be continued to January 14th.
Any questions on that? Okay.
Item number 5, ordinance number 2012-198, to authorize the CAO to execute an amended non-exclusive license agreement between the city as licensor and Megabus Northeast LLC as licensee for the purpose of increasing the license fee and extending Megabus Northeast LLC non-exclusive right to a certain bus stop, passenger boarding, and waiting area at the plaza directly across from the Main Street station.
Any questions on that? Okay.
Item number 6, ordinance number 2012-199, to amend and reordain ordinance number 2012-45-60, adopted May 14, 2012, which appropriates and provides funds for financing the school budget for the fiscal year commencing July 1, 2012 and ending June 30, 2013, for the purpose of appropriating an additional $4,402,955 in state revenue and revenue classified as other.
Any questions on that?
Just want the administration to confirm with me, this is an additional $4.4 million from the state. Earlier this year, they had provided $1.9 million additional, now they're giving an additional $4.4. Is that accurate?
That was my understanding. Is there anybody that can answer this specific question? Well, I guess the question is, this is not city money, this is state money, correct?
Right, and I also wanted to confirm that this is...
state money and not city money. Is there a confirmation of that?
Okay, that's fine.
All right, number 7 is...
Well, I'm sorry, I didn't hear the answer.
We're getting the answer.
Okay,
we're going to get back to it. Number 7 is continue.
Yes, I
have a question. Okay, number 8.
Number 8 is ordinance number 2012-201. That is to amend Chapter 14, Article 1 of the City Code by adding and varying new sections 14 and 16 concerning the streamlined process for the approval of building permits when green roofs are used for the purpose of encouraging the use of green roofs as defined by the Virginia Code by providing for the processing of building permit applications within 10 business days and an associated plumbing, electrical, and mechanical permit application within 5 business days.
Are there any questions on that?
Item number 9, ordinance number 2012-203, to authorize the CAO to execute a master agreement for the use of Commonwealth transportation funds between the city and the Virginia Department of Rail and Public Transportation for the purpose of utilizing grant proceeds from the department.
Any questions on that? Okay.
Item number 10, to authorize the CAO on behalf of the city to execute a grant agreement between the city and the Federal Transit Administration for the purpose of receiving federal funding of $10,031,620 to fund the capital improvements at the Main Street Station.
Questions? Okay.
Item number 11, ordinance number 2012-207, to accept $59,671 from the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency and to appropriate increase to fiscal year 2012-13 stormwater utility budget for the purpose of forming a watershed coalition and developing watershed to develop a watershed concept plan to restore the creek adjacent to the Old Grove Elementary School.
Questions? And I think maybe in the, to appreciate our time constraints, maybe if you just read the number.
Okay.
Everybody can take a second and look at it and see if there are any questions.
Okay.
So it would be number 12, 2012-208.
Okay.
Are there any questions on that? Okay.
Item number 13, ordinance 2012-217.
Any questions on that one?
Item number 14.
Wait, don't go too fast, because everybody's looking at it. Everybody's good with that? Number 13. Any questions? Okay.
Item number 14, ordinance number 2012-218.
Any questions on that? Okay.
Item number 15, ordinance number 2012-219.
Questions? Okay.
Item number 16, ordinance number 2012-220.
All right, and this was forwarded to council from finance with no recommendation. Yes, ma'am.
I've had discussion with the administration in regards to that to clarify my concerns and questions and support this paperwork.
Does anyone else have any questions on this paper?
Yeah, I'd like to know.
Mr. Joel?
I'd like to know the circumstances around it.
This paper is a support. There are two tax credit applications for the redevelopment of the Ford community. This paper provides for the opportunity to enter into the agreement for the appropriation of the second round of tax credits.
It is a loan.
The revenue is, yes, through the VHDA, through the tax credits that they get the loan from VHDA.
My understanding that the housing authority had the funds to do this project. The LLC probably did not. Why are we going to help with a loan when I thought the funds were there for the housing authority? What am I missing?
The LLC actually makes the application for the loan, and so the loan is awarded to the LLC. This established the relationship with the housing authority, and the LLC will receive other tax credits. But I'll let Mr. Johnson come for questions for you.
Good afternoon. My name is Brian Johnson, and I'm the Chief Credit Officer for the Department of Economic and Community Development. To your question, this is actually phase two of the project. In phase one, there was no city participation, which is the ongoing phase. This is phase two of an additional 48 units. And this money was approved by council in the non-departmental FY13 budget. And this paper gives the CEO the authorization to enter into a cooperation agreement so that we can disperse those.
So it was anticipated. I got it. Thank you.
Thank you. Any questions on that? Okay.
Well,
next paper, finance recommended striking.
That is correct.
Any questions on that? Number 18.
Item number 18, resolution 2012-R1.
Any questions on that?
Item number 21, resolution 2012-45.
Any questions on that one? Okay.
Item number 22, resolution 2012-46.
Okay, any questions on that? All right, let's go to the regular agenda and let's take the master plan first. We're from master plan number 37.
Thank you.